Hi, it's Giulia here and welcome to my channel. I just want to make a video because I was in a good mood. And that doesn't really happen often, or something always happens and my mood changes. Today I also went to therapy and it was good. Also, just by the way, if someone doesn't know therapy, at least normally, it says it's an hour, but it's actually 45 minutes, because the last like 50 minutes the therapist, it's usually after you leave, has to take notes and document it and things like that. So that's why you get 45 minutes of an actual hour. And sometimes you lose track of time and you want to keep saying things, but it ends, so that's what can happen at times. And it didn't happen this time, but I just wanted to say that it's okay to cry at therapy. That's why there is therapy, but you don't have to cry at therapy. But if you have some emotional baggage, how am I speaking? I don't know. Emotional package that you're carrying, and well, cry or tear up and just share it, just gets it off your chest and you feel better after, because therapy is a place where you can feel safe, where you can communicate openly how you're feeling and what's going on in your life. You say the things usually that you cannot tell other people, or you may feel like a burden if you say it to other people. You're afraid they might react in a way that you don't want it to react to other people. So, therapy is just... Also, just wanted to say that you don't have to have a mental illness or anything in particular to have to go to a therapist. For example, my therapist has a therapy to deal with like all the things that she has to go through for her work, to deal with the things that she hears and throughout her days with dealing with people who have a lot of things to say, because of course it takes a toll on an emotion. It can just be for people who are in a stressful situation, who just want someone to talk to. So it can be for anybody who wants to. I just wanted to say about that, or ramble about it. I'm just saying what comes to mind. This is very not scripted. Also, yes, I am in a different location. This is a chair, actually an Italian chair. It has a weird shape, I know, but it's very comfortable. So I'm sitting here today. And maybe I'm just, I don't know. Maybe in this video you can see more of my personality, I guess. Maybe you can still see it in other videos, but maybe because now I'm at the house alone, so I can talk as loud as I want without bothering anybody else. So maybe you also see more of my personality, and I'm more in a good, happy mood. So, well, you see a different side of me, because maybe in some of these videos I might be able to talk a bit low, not as happy, have something going on, because having something going on, though, that's life. And no one has really, I don't really receive any comments at the moment, but I just wanted to address my accent. Yes, I'm Italian, that's why I have an accent. Well, not all Italian people necessarily have to have an accent. I did come here when I was, I cannot do something with one hand, the other one is holding the camera, so okay. I did come here when I was 7, okay, maybe that works, 7 years old, to the US. I don't think I've said it before, but here in the US I live in Miami, and I know I'm 17, my birthday is January 21st, 2001, yeah, well, you said it correctly. And and I've been living here for 10 years, about, yeah, I'm 17 now, and, oh yeah, my accent. I'm from Italy, in a place, well, 20 regions in Italy. In Italy it's called Regioni. I'm from the region that is called Friuli Venezia Giulia, which, yes, my name is Giulia. That is spelled, by the way, G-I-U-L-A-A, which is in my, of course, my channel name is Giulia Senatore, which is just simply my name. But so many people misspell it, and I wanted to make, so that's kind of why I wanted to make my username, because some people have said before, like, so people have said my name wrong and spelled it wrong in so many ways. People have called me Julia, Giulia, Guilia, I think even Guilia, Giuliana, or maybe even Juliana. At least no one has ever called me Giuliana. And also spelling it wrong many times. Some teachers have added Giulia with two L's. They're taking out of the I, it's normal. Like, I cannot say my name. Like, my name is Giulia, like when people had to write it without people like starting with the J. So I always have to spell it before. So that's why I'm used to like voice spelling my name. Because I know Americans, so like people, many of people living in America are used to spelling out words. I'm not used to spelling out words. I'm only really good at spelling out my name because since I was about to say 2 years old, but because, no. But since since I was in second grade, meaning 7 years old here in the United States, I've had to learn how to spell my name kind of fast. I mean, like G-I-U-L-A-A and my last name S-E-N-A-T-O-R-E, because so many people misspell it wrong, or like for like any type of like documents or things when you ask your name and they have to write it correctly. I just got used to saying it, is it called syllable by syllable? Like letter for letter? No, syllable is another thing, yeah. Letter by letter, so people actually spell it correctly, because many people don't, if not. Anyway, if I tell you how to spell it correctly, over time they spell it wrong anyways. So yeah, my accent, I have an accent. I'm from I said that there were 20 regions, regioni, in, I was about to say in Italia, but in Italy. The one I'm from is called Friuli Venezia Giulia, and Giulia is in the name. My parents didn't call me Giulia because of that. It just happens to be a coincidence, I just like the name, okay? And in the province of Pordenone, and a little, like, even smaller place where I live there and I still have an apartment in Italy, is called Cordenones. And, like, the Latin name is called Cortenone. No, Cortenones. Okay. Maybe it's irrelevant facts. And also, usually when I describe where I live to people, or like in America, say I live in Italy, northeast of Venice, an hour away, and it's not on water, because some people say, oh, near Venice, and may think it's on water, but it's not where I live. And on the airport of Venice, because it's like an hour away, it's the closest one, is the closest one to where I live, so I can get to Miami to here, so I know it pretty well. Also, I don't know if I ever said it before, but I've also traveled a lot, kind of. In Italy, I've been to Liguria, which is kind of like, it's also called a place called Mar di Liguria, which is kind of like the sea for Liguria, which is like the hill shape. This is like the, this is kind of the hill, like the top part, north and west, I think. Wait, north and west side, kind of like the, I don't know how to show it exactly. I've been also to Toscana, I think it's said Tuscany in English. I've been to Rome one summer, Venice as well when I was younger, maybe also other places, so I don't know. I've been also outside of Italy, I've been to Spain, I forgot where it happened when I was little. I've been also to France one time, to like the seaside, I don't remember the name right now, but not Paris. My mom has been to Paris, but like that's like on her own, or maybe with my dad, I forgot. But I've been there also. I've also in Italy, I've also been to Puglia, which I have no idea how to say it in English, but you can. Also, I wanted to say that a good like translating website that you can use, because the what's it called, like Google Translator is not very good. A better one is what, don't I remember the name? I'm probably going to put a link below or something, because I don't remember the name right now. But there's better ones, I just wanted to say that. My mind is all over the place, I don't know what's wrong with it. This is a very rambly video. Will I edit this? I have no idea. Anyways. Oh, other places that I visited, I've also been to different places in the United States. I've been one summer, I've been to New Orleans. I've also been to like different national parks. I've been to different national parks like the Grand Canyon, Mountain Valley, Arches National Park, and other types of like canyon-based national parks over there. I forgot the states that they were in, but I did that like maybe 2 summers ago or more. I don't remember this time, but I went like about like 1 week at two different parks, just looking and being kind of tourist, you know. And also before that, I've been to, what's it called again? Why doesn't the name come to me? No. Ah, Las Vegas. I've been to Las Vegas, but I didn't really like it. I guess people like the casinos and such. I don't really like it that much. And I remember like one of the things was like the, like when also people take many photos, which I did of course do that as well. There is like a inside Venice where like there are gondolas, entire gondola, which there are like long boats where there is like usually a person standing who like rows the boats, and then you can go there. But of course we didn't do that there because it's expensive and very unnecessary. But it was like a shopping mall, and there were like all like malls around it. It was like on water, like all the ceiling was color, like all blue and like almost lifelike. And the water was actually clear. That's how you know it's not actually the real Venice, because the water is clear and that's not reality at all. Just to let you know, if you didn't know that fact, but the water in Venice, it's a problem more than one ways. Because also the water is rising up, which is a problem, and things like that. But also it's very dirty, so I wouldn't suggest anyone to ever like go inside the actual Venice water. Anyways, okay. Yeah, I was talking about national. Oh, yeah. Las Vegas. That was kind of the only place that I actually kind of liked. It's just a lot of expensive shops and weird like things to look at. It was nice to visit, but I prefer the national parks in the. Well. Like, we went there, like, at first, and then after, like, went to all the other national parks. And I think I actually prefer the Arches National Park. You should probably look into it or, like, look at photos of how beautiful it is, because I actually prefer it in comparison to the more well-known Grand Canyon and also Mountain Valley, which Mountain Valley is a place where at times they have filmed, like, all Western movies. I didn't know this before, but my dad told me, so I don't really like Western movies, so you know, like in Western movies, I think it's, I don't know, also when people are about to battle, like the high thing, like, and then also the times the music changes. I like that part, but other than that, for me it's just boring, I guess. I don't know. You might like it, but it's okay. This is a video where I ramble a lot. It's not maybe. Maybe only the first part when I talk about therapy was important, the rest. If you want, you can watch it just to get to know me as a person. And more about my life, I guess. Parapam. Also, I talk a lot to myself, you see. Talking to myself on the camera. I talk to myself in three languages. Italian, English, and also a bit of Spanish at times. I don't know that much of Spanish, but I like to at times. I don't know. Or maybe I'm not going to take Spanish next year, but I did for a while. Well, the last, like, yeah, 3 years of, was about to say middle school, or no, high school, I didn't take Spanish, but the teachers weren't always that great. Like, for the first 2 years, I had one teacher, so, like, I didn't learn a lot. Like, the first year, I learned more, but the second year, like, not that much. Oh, yeah, I talked to myself in three languages. In Italian, like, also with my family, it feels weird talking in English. To the camera, I guess, it's easier talking in English. Also, I talk in English to the camera because it's more international and more people are around the world. Or around the world can probably understand me. But yes, I do talk with an accent. Some people find it hard to understand. Others are like it. Oh, I love your accent. I do get compliments about that. Also with English, I don't know why, maybe because I lived here for so long, it's easier for me to write about my emotions, or like, I like to journal in English usually, unless it's, I don't know, something that I get irritated in Italian with my family times, but usually my journal, like, my emotions or like my spoken word, like, I don't translate them, they're like originally in English and they stay that way, and at times talk about my emotional self-expression, I do it better in English. In Spanish, like, I don't know that much, it's more like for fun. And but also think about being Italian and having a thick Italian accent, especially here in Miami, some people assume I speak Spanish, and even if I do, I hate when I start speaking I was about to say Spanish, but I start speaking English with them. Like, my mom might start speaking English, and sometimes me and my mom, like, she might understand less. I talk to her, and then the other person just starts speaking randomly in Spanish to us, thinking that Spanish is easier for us. It's not. And even if it was, I find it kind of disrespectful, and it just irritates me about people who just, like, start speaking another language. Another language, where here in Miami is mostly just Spanish to us without not even asking if it's better. Or every time I mention I'm Italian, like, say, oh, I have this person, like, my grand something is Italian, like, oh, I went to Italy once, or like, I'm part Italian, or something like that. I don't know, so, like, it's like, okay, but I don't know, like, I had the guy that I'm Italian, but doesn't really have to do that much with me. I don't know, but always, like, when people say in Italian, oh, how nice, or, like, I don't know, I'm used to these comments by now, well, 10 years, you know, but I still find it kind of weird, I don't know, like, at least in Miami, here, like, oh, it's, like, it's always seen as a positive, it's a good thing, it's been Italian, and I get recognized, not recognized, but, like, they see the distinct voice, but, like, at times, some people are like, I don't know, or like my brothers these times, like, when people ask where I'm from, he wants me to say some other, like, weird thing, or like a language that they don't know, so they cannot prove that I'm not talking, like he wanted me to say, like, I speak Turkish or something like that, but I don't know, I don't do that. So yeah, I don't know if I should end my video now. So my camera says 19:50 minutes. been a long time, but maybe you get to know, you see more of my personality than that I can actually be loud, because many of my videos come, hi, I'm Giulia, how are you, blah, blah, blah. I don't really say that, but that was me trying to give an example for what I sound like when I have to talk more quietly because there's other people in the house and I don't want them to hear me. Yay! Okay, yes, I'm weird and I know that. Anyways, I think that's all for this video. If you want to watch other videos and get to know me in other ways, or like get to see other things that I put out, you can subscribe if you want to. I'm not forcing, but if you want, you can do that. If you survive this video, you can probably survive the other ones. Well, some of them are longer and more intense, but I think they are interesting and well, it might be biased at opinion, but they may have some information that may help you, might help someone you know who struggles with things or with life and stuff in general. Also, I don't know, if you said this long into this video, well, congratulations, because it is a long time of just hearing me ramble about anything and, well, everything. So then, if you have any suggestions for me or anything that whoever is watching me might want me to do, or like if you want me to do a video in Italian or explaining anything, please leave a comment down below. I don't know, I'm used to this YouTuber stuff. I don't really call myself a YouTuber. I just make videos on YouTube. Maybe that does count as a YouTube though. Anyways, I'll talk on a camera. I post a video on YouTube and every time, so stay tuned. Bye for now. And now close.